So how do we make ourselves more secure without sacrificing the benefits of innovation and technological advances? A knee-jerk reaction might be to regulate the Internet of Things. And while I'm not taking certain level of regulation off the table, the question is whether we need a more holistic approach.
For the first time, the Internet affects the world in a direct and physical manner. And the second point I'm going to make very quickly is we need to resist the FBI's calls to weaken these devices in their attempt to solve crimes. We have to prioritize security over surveillance. It was okay when it was fun and games. But now, I mean, already there's stuff on this device that monitors my medical condition, controls my thermostat, talks to my car. Right? I mean, I've just crossed four regulatory agencies, and it's not even 11 o'clock. So I see the choice is not between government involvement and no government involvement, but between smart government involvement and stupid government involvement.
I'd rather think
about it now, even if you say you don't want this, because when something happens and the public says something must be done, what do you mean 1,000 people just died? That we have something more than, I don't know, let's figure it out fast.
Mm-hmm. We're going to have some serious trouble if we don't answer these questions. I fear for the day where every hospital system is down, for instance, because an IoT attack brings down the entire healthcare system. Yeah. Typically, it's a clinician who accidentally connects a device to a very important network, but maybe it's a music player that is simply providing comfort to the patients during surgery, and they don't realize it's introducing new safety and security risks, because they don't have the security baked into these devices. So the IoT risk is more about having unvetted assets coming into a very safety-critical arena. They don't have a good answer right now, and that's okay. Because it's not built in.